This is Gladys Yangi. In the past 3 months, her daily morning routine involves wearing gumboots and wrapping a piece of cloth around her waist. This is all in preparation as she picks a handhoe for the tilling of her garden at Boroli Refugee Settlement in Adjumani District. At 17 years, Gladys is the oldest child among 13 children in an extended refugee family.
If I do it, I will sell it, I will get money, I will pay it, I will help my parents, that thing. Even I will sell it, the other one we are eating. My mother is there looking baby, for me I will look my thing. We need food to help, but the baby is small, we need to eat. Even the problem, no problem from home, my father is taking the baby.
But for Gladys, she has to work even harder. 3 months ago, she gave birth to a baby girl. She was a primary six pupil by then. The father of the child was sent to prison for defilement, so Gladys has to buy clothes, food, soap, and ensure that the child is healthy.
Sabuni, yongo tarezo, baparu nani baby nani tarezo yo.
That if you can help, you give them food and clothes for the babies, then
yongo school fees ina kumkupa.
The story of Gladys Yangi is similar to that of hundreds of young mothers in the 19 settlements in Adjumani District.
25 years old, I have children, but the ratio normally that they give us is not enough for us.
Annette Alum is a 25-year-old mother of three. She says the current financial and food support given to refugees in these settlements is not enough to sustain most families.
I came from South Sudan and I came here, I am about 7 years now. And my life here in Uganda is that where normally we are based on waiting for the food ratio that is being brought for us by UNHCR. And right now, currently, as I am staying, I even did not yet rent a garden. I am waiting for the ratio to come.
But the situation in these refugee settlements could even get worse as the Office of the Prime Minister, the World Food Programme and the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees have announced that effective 1st July 2023, some refugees will be removed from the list to benefit from monthly food rations and money.
Everyone should be empowered to do something for survival, because as the funds are going on, we might find out that in future you find that the food is not there. The donor funding, it has been going down due to COVID-19. Most of the donors have died and the money is in the account we cannot get.
The Office of the Prime Minister, UNHCR and their partner Voice for Humanity have now embarked on a Go campaign to empower more refugees with farming tools such as handhoes and seeds of fast-growing vegetables. This is meant to prepare the refugees to become self-reliant.
Number three, why I'm so happy today, like everyone has said, we don't have money these days. The gurusu has gone like this. And he has told that when you dig and get around 12 million, you're going to support your family, isn't it?
The Go campaign is targeting young refugees from the ages of 14 to 25.
UN is incapacitated, and so they are shifting into what we call a targeted ratio, whereby some of the refugees are going to be weaned off from receiving food ratio as of July. So these efforts are really to empower the refugee communities to be able to be self-sustaining and be able to produce their own food, and some of it in excess be able to sell and earn income.
However, as an agronomist, Adukule Deogracias believes that as the refugees are being prepared to take up farming, they should also be given farming knowledge.
Vegetables are high earning or high returning crops. They would range from 1 acre, most of them range from, let's say, 6 million to even around 40 million or even plus. Let's take an example of tomatoes. In tomatoes, 1 acre takes like 12,000 plants. In a worst scenario, if one tomato plant gives you 1,000 shillings, let's say you've done very well, planted timely, you've sprayed chemicals. So the lowest limit that you get from a plant is 1,000 shillings. Those are like 10 fruits.
The reduction in the monthly food ratios and money meant for refugees is being attributed to the international dwindling of resources. David Elungat is the executive director of Voice for Humanity. He has overseen the mobilization of refugees like Gladys Yangi in the quest to make them self-reliant.
And targeting 110 refugee youth here in Boroli Refugee Settlement. It started from this month, May, up to July.
Currently, each refugee receives 21,000 shillings each month as upkeep money. There is also an option to receive about 6 cups of maize grains and beans. I am Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Adjumani District.
Of Humanity, oye!
Oye!